And welcome to CIO News, Voice of CIO series. I'm Khushbu Soni, your host for the broadcast and a contributing editor at CIO News, where we write about business strategy and boardroom issues for technology leaders. This is a recorded session and will be available on our CIO News LinkedIn page and our website, which is cionews.co.in. Let me dive in introducing my guest for today. He's Rajneesh Sheth, the Chief Information Officer at Vikings Ventures Private Limited. Rajneesh has been, with a good 30 years of rich experience in the IT industry, leading business and technology transformation for various organizations. Rajneesh is a tech and business visionary with strong record of setting up robust IT infrastructure and architecture for different organizations. Welcome, Rajneesh.
Yeah, hi. Good morning, Khushbu.
Good morning. Thank you so much, Rajneesh, for taking our time for this interview today.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Great. So, Rajneesh, let's start with, if you can share insights, you know, as the industry continues to undergo the major change, what role should IT perform to help businesses be successful?
Yes. So, Khushbu, basically, let us go a little back, in October last year, around this time.
Yeah.
And, you know, the businesses around the world were already experiencing, you know, a heightened trade war. And then, you know, suddenly we were all hit by this pandemic.
Right.
And, you know, the most of the businesses were taken by surprise and got unprepared to handle these crises of such a huge magnitude.
Yeah.
And, you know, for such a longer period of time.
Yeah.
Now, you know, to address these kind of crises, you know, which is once in a 100 years kind of a phenomena.
Yeah.
You know, we cannot continue doing the same things which we were doing prior to pandemic.
True.
Right? And so, you know, what I feel is, you know, most of the businesses would need to undergo a complete transformation of their business models, you know.
Right.
And, you know, because many companies will need to go through the complete transformation of business models, the way they interact, the way they sell, the way they service their customer, the
yeah.
way they procure and manufacture, and, you know, the way their employees work.
Yeah.
Because the employee culture has completely changed. You know, we all used to meet in office every day, and now, you know, we are meeting on Zoom today.
True.
Right? So the way, you know, things are moving, the mere digitization
yeah.
is not going to help the businesses.
Right.
What we need is a strategic approach of, you know, transforming the business model completely 360 degrees. Using technologies like, you know, artificial intelligence, machine learning,
yeah.
robotics, you know, robotics, process automation, Internet of Things. You know, I see huge potential in this kind of crisis for factories to, you know, implement, you know, simple IoT solutions like, you know, environment monitoring. Now, we are still not doing it in each and every factory of our country, which is a, you know, very standard IoT solution. And that can help us, you know, improve the product quality. So this is what I feel, that, you know, a complete business transformation is required. IT leaders, historically, you know, we all are used to identify or receive a business problem,
yeah.
identify, you know, a use case out of it, and then, you know, using technology to solve it.
Right.
Now, here also, we need to change our approach. Every project, you know, or every initiative which we take, either it should increase my profitability, it should decrease my cost, it should help me, you know, make my customers more satisfied, make my customer more loyal to my organization.
Right.
It should also help me for, you know, for my employees to, you know, be work more efficiently and, you know, increase the employee satisfaction also.
True. Yeah. Rajneesh, based on your understanding of the industry and your knowledge that you possess, what are your initial thoughts on the approach that CIO should take and keep their focus on?
What I told you in the beginning is, you know, a downside of the pandemic. Now, let's look at the positive side of it.
Yeah.
Now, what has happened is, this is kind of a scenario where definitely there is a, you know, reduction in the demand from the consumer and the customer. Simultaneously, there is a huge disruption on the supply side.
Correct.
Right? So there were many factories which were manufacturing a lot of goods. They have been shut down. Yeah. And it will take little while for them to, you know, get on to the business. Though they have started coming on to the business again, but it will take a while. So yeah. While this is, you know, we all call pandemic as a crisis, this is also an opportunity. You know, the few handful companies who have been able to sustain this kind of, you know, situation has a huge opportunity
right.
to increase their market share, to gain a competitive advantage, and to, you know, get a, you know, quantum leap towards, you know, customer acquisition.
Correct.
And that's where, you know, I think CIO must focus.
Right.
So A, they must change their business model to suit the new requirement. And secondly, how quickly, how fast they can capture the market share which is right now available openly to be, you know, captured. Because a lot of companies have gone out of business.
Right.
Right. So this is where CIO must focus. They must use technologies like, again, I'll say AI, ML, and, you know, robotics and RPA, you know, to achieve all these goals.
Right. Your views on future of the work and, you know, what percentage of work will remain digital post-COVID as for you?
Right. So, Khushru, what will happen as I discussed that, you know, there are going to be technology implementation mm-hmm. on a strategic level. And definitely, you know, the work is not going to be remain the same as it was earlier.
Right.
There are going to be a lot of, you know, roles which will be obsolete
mm-hmm.
and there will be a lot of new roles which will be created.
Yeah.
Right. So that change is inevitable.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as the percentage of digital work, I think culturally we all agree now that, you know, the work can be done anywhere.
Yeah.
It can be done from office, it can be done from home, it could be done from anywhere.
Right.
So that cultural change is going to happen. However, there are debates here that, you know, if, you know, for example, if IT professionals, they want to work from their tier 2 cities,
yeah.
from their home, what is the infrastructure available and, you know, whether they can do that or not.
Correct.
But, you know, that's a debatable subject and, you know, infrastructure will only improve now onward. It's not
yeah.
going to degrade. So this is what I feel, you know, that the roles are going to be changed
right.
upside down. Because when we are talking about change in the business model, it is necessary that, you know, even the roles will change. So
true.
That's what I think.
Great. Great, Rajneesh. I think that is it from my side. I just have one last question. I know you've started writing a lot, you know, started blogging a lot, and we've published a lot of your articles as well. Any other hobby, any new thing that you've learned in this lockdown, which is apart from all the work that we've been doing?
Well, I have started doing more meditation because I got a lot of time.
Uh-huh.
I had to do a lot of, you know, office time and home time managing
right.
because it was very much overlapped with each other. But
right.
I'm still struggling with that, I would admit.
Everybody is.
But I think I started more meditating. I started looking more inwards rather than, you know, external world. So this is what I learned from a technology expertise point of view. Yes, I have learned quite a few things. I have started, you know, studying. I have taken up one hobby project on the machine learning, which I'll be publishing once I am able to make a breakthrough.
Right, right. Okay, great. That is great. Good to hear from you, Rajneesh. And thank you so much for sharing all your views and insights with us on CIO News. Thank you for taking out the time.
Thank you, Khushbu. Thank you for having me. It was nice talking to you. Thank you.
Same here. Thank you.
Bye.
Good day. Bye.
Yeah.